Assalamu alaikum and good day to audience. So welcome back to our massive open online course on public speaking. So today is our big day. This is delivery of a speech. That's our topic today. And how to deliver a good speech then. All right. We would like to share with you what actually is good delivery. First one, the most important is very clear is that your ideas are clear. So whatever you deliver to them, it has to be very clear. And also make sure your presentation does not distract the audience. Well, the contents must be interesting to them. If possible, try then to make something spontaneously done. This is what the audience really love to hear from you. The next, your vocal and facial expressiveness. And then you cannot just be dry there and try to be expressive, because people love to see people who are very expressive and try to show that you are really, really delivering, you know, your speech in this very good way. The next one, and try to have a lively sense of communication. This is very important for a good presentations. And also don't forget then to establish a good eye contact with your audience. Next, I have some tips for you if you like to have a good delivery. Number one, by knowing all these informations that you must, first one, keep practicing. You know a lot of theories, but most important, you need to keep practicing. And number two, there is no substitute actually for experiences. The more you practice, the more confident you will be, the more speaker you will be. Well, next one, I would like to share with you some methods of delivery when we talk about public speaking. I believe that you have seen many speakers in your life. Firstly, I believe you have seen someone reading from a manuscript, or we call it manuscript speech. What is this methods of delivery all about? When we talk about reading from a manuscript, normally this is a speech which is written in advance by using, you know, word per word and read to the audience. So the speaker just simply reads this speech to the audience. One good thing about this method is that everything is meticulously prepared in advance. So the manuscript is perfect because it has been prepared way, way much in advance. And of course, the accuracy is absolutely essential, because the presenter has a lot of time to check and recheck the content. If you see then, you know, presidential speech or prime minister speech is done by using this reading from manuscript. This one advice for you, if you like to do this one, you just do a little bit of practice aloud to make sure the speech sounds natural, even though you read it, so you can do it as if you are speaking in front of your audience. That's the first one, reading from a manuscript. And also you can do, and some do work on establishing your eye contact with the listeners. This is part of the reading from the manuscript. Even though you are reading, don't forget then to keep contact with your audience. Well, we move on to the second one. We call it a reciting from memory. If you could recall and try to recall some great orators, some great speakers that you know of, mostly they recite. They try then to speak, you know, by using the memory. We consider them as legendary orators, you name them. Yes, seasoned orators, very outstanding orators, yeah, who use this type of methods. They memorize the content, truly. So it means there's no such thing for reading. But of course, they need to concentrate on communicating with the audience. One good thing about reciting from memory is that they have plenty of time to look at the audience while they are speaking. The next one, you may have heard about speaking impromptu. You might be attending a function suddenly out of the blue, and then someone asks you to present or to talk in front of the audience. You give a speech without any preparations. But don't panic, don't worry. So actually, the notion of speaking impromptu is delivery, you know, with little or no preparation at all. But actually, as I mentioned, don't panic, because no one expects you, you know, to have a great speech, just because really this is an impromptu speech. Well, we would like to advise you some tips then. If you were to be, you know, asked then to give speech, you know, in front of audience, it's very last minute, what you should do firstly, you must make sure you state the point that you wish to make. You just get some rough ideas, maybe one or two, three ideas that you really want to deliver. And right after you have the points, you can support every point that you have with some examples, illustrations, to make them, you know, solid. The next one. Step number three, once you finish giving the 3 points with some example, you can start summarizing, yeah, your points. That's as simple as, so that's considered as speaking impromptu. It can happen in your life.